So Zoe, why don't we start talking about the pieces that we actually picked, and we can start with the casual line.
Yeah, I think that's the easiest place to start. So casual, what comes to mind? Again, classics, a Rolex Daytona. I just recently sold one. It's a Rolex Daytona 1601. It was silver dial, stainless steel, a great everyday piece. It literally goes with everything. It could even be a dress watch. But for me, this was my casual watch piece. It has creamy loom plots, which just shows the beautiful aging of this watch. And yeah, this is immediately, it was no question. I had a couple of other watches going back and forth for the other categories, but for my casual watch, this was it. This is what I think of when I think of casual. I personally have a Rolex Datejust with a blue dial and Roman numerals, which is a little bit funkier, a little bit different. This, to me, is a great casual everyday watch. It, as I mentioned, it goes with everything.
So for my casual watch, something pretty different than Zoe. I picked a Hublot Classic Fusion Titanium. This particular piece that I have here is a little larger. They do make this in a variation of sizes. I'd probably personally go with a 38 just because it would fit my wrist the best, but they make a big variation. The reason I picked this watch is, first of all, I'm a huge Hublot fan. Everybody, you know, teases me a little bit about it, but I love Hublot. I think they're an innovative company. I think they do a really classic, cool design. And this particular piece is titanium, so it's really lightweight. And if I'm gonna be wearing something every day, you know, I don't want something heavy that's gonna wear me down. As I also mentioned, I don't like to wear a bracelet at work. It destroys my computer and it destroys the watch. So I happen to really like this Hublot gummy strap. It has the alligator finish on the outside and the rubber on the inside. So it's practical in the summer months when, you know, your wrist gets a little sweaty. It's there to sort of protect the straps. The lifespan of them is really long. And I overall just think it's a pretty cool watch that I would be really excited to wake up and wear every single day. And again, it's cool that they make them in all sorts of sizes, so they can be suited to men, suited to women, small wrists, big wrists. Everything of the sorts.
I totally agree. I also think, although Hublot is not really my style, I do really like that piece, and I do think it's extremely versatile. You could wear it with any color, any outfit, and it will be a good casual watch. So I'm actually with you on that. Again, not my pick, but I like it.
Yeah, and you know what? The practicality of it as well. It has a date, which for me, you know, I love a watch like the Daytona. It'd be fantastic. But I do like having a date on it, and it's easy to read. So that would be my casual pick.
All right, and for dress, where would you go for dress watch?
Yeah, so this was probably the hardest one for me to pick. To be quite honest, when I think of dress watches, I think of diamonds. And I didn't know how our viewers would react to that, so I tried to pick a watch that was somewhere in between. I ended up going with a JLC Master Ultra Thin Moon, in particular the Q136255J, which is a rose gold case with a black dial. I happen to think it's an extremely sharp watch and something pretty special. The reason that I picked JLC for the dress watch is because it's sort of the best combination of mechanics and look. It's what I spent the most money on in my $30,000. I'd say you could get one somewhere between $12,000 and $13,000 pre-owned. So I picked it and put most of my money into that because it's something that I would want to keep forever, and because it's something that it's special and I'm wearing it to special events, I figured that would be a good place to put the money. You know, it sits in the safe most of the time, and then sometimes you get to take it out and rock it for a special occasion. I also think, again, for your money, having a complication for a special event is pretty special, and the moon phase on it, it's something I happen to love. What did you choose?
So I also want to mention that the Rolex Datejust that I mentioned for my casual watch, I know we're tallying up to make sure that you only spend $30,000, and I just reached below that mark with the watches that I picked. It was really hard. But so that Datejust that I mentioned before, the 1601, you can usually get for around $2,500 to $3,000, depending on if it has the original box and papers and the condition of it. So that's where I spent kind of a conservative amount of money. My dress piece, I actually have this piece that we have in our pre-owned inventory. It is a JLC Grand Reverso Duoface Blue. I think it's an extremely sharp looking watch. It's beautiful. It's quintessential for a dress piece. Now, it's funny because they originally were designed for sport, for polo, but I think it's really paved the way in being a classic dress watch. Now, for me, I love the blue. I already have a blue date dress dial, but I do think that if I had a pick of the litter, I would say that the tribute to 1931 with the New York City skyline would be my go-to. I think that would be my go-to dress piece. I'm from New York originally. I just moved to Philly in December, so it would pay homage to my background and where I grew up. And always, whenever I am taking the train from Philadelphia to New York, that skyline is what excites me. So I would love to have that on my watch. And I believe the retail on that originally was $9,200. You can probably get it for cheaper on the secondary market. And yeah, that would be my dress watch that I picked.
I see a lot of comments about the JLC drinking game. You all are welcome to start it out. As you can see, we all love JLC here. It's an incredible brand. And obviously Zoe and I both think so, since we picked those for our dress watches.
Yeah, that's really interesting. That I think that says a lot that we both, when we thought of dress watches, we both went JLC.
Yeah. And you know what, Zoe, I think you made a great choice on the Reverso. I see a lot of people that come in and they're buying Reversos for special occasions. I actually have a really good friend that's getting married in about a year, and he came in early just to pick out the right watch, and he's going to be wearing a Reverso with a navy strap for his wedding, and it's going to look pretty sharp with a navy suit. So, great choice.
Thank you.
Next, we have up sport. Again, for me, this was a pretty easy thing to choose. I saw some comments a little earlier on about how there's definitely going to be a Submariner mentioned. And yes, here is the Submariner. I picked a Rolex ceramic Submariner, a contemporary piece. As I've mentioned a couple times in our show, I generally gravitate towards contemporary pieces. I think it's the aesthetic of them, just how they're built out these days. I really love it. I will say a Submariner has always been a watch that's in my world. My dad bought one for himself after he finished dental school in the 70s, and he still wears it every single day, keeps incredible time. So the reason I picked this watch for sport is because I think everybody can agree the Rolex Submariner is a tank of a watch. It is perfect for everyday wear. It's perfect for activity. It's going to stand up well to the test of time. Rolex is a fantastic service industry. They're really good at, they have a 5-year warranty when you buy it new. They'll service it, back it with a warranty afterwards. So, you know, it's like a good solid piece. Yeah, and from a value standpoint as well, I don't think there's anything better out there than a Rolex. You know, from the vintage market, which I'm sure Zoe can talk about, you know, you see ones that have dots and this and that, and they're worth bajillions of dollars. And then even just the ceramic ones, they hold up their value really well over time. So that is my pick for the sport. And Zoe, what did you decide on?
I thought immediately Submariner or Daytona. Daytona for me would be where I would start, just because it's the quintessential sports watch. I think that the 116520, although a little bit less sought after now that the new ceramic bezel is out, it's still a really, really wonderful piece. This is one that we currently have for pre-owned. You can usually get them for around $11,500 to $2,000, again, based on if it has box and papers and the condition. This is just a piece that screams sports watch to me, and this was my pick.
You definitely can't go wrong with a Daytona. The only thing I'll say is it's tough, again, for me for a sports watch to not have a date, but obviously you then get the chrono function, which is a nice function to have on a sports watch. And I happen to love the steel Daytona. I mean, I think it's classic, will never go out of style.
Yeah.
It's a great choice.
I think if I had to pick for the older model, the 116520, I would pick a white dial. But for the newer, the black ceramic, I think similar to the black dial, black bezel on the Submariner, the black dial Daytona for the newer piece is so sharp. And some people like the white dial because it kind of pays homage to the Paul Newman. But I love the black dial, black bezel, new Daytona. That would be where I would go if I was going in that direction.